Welcome to another video by PythonPool. In this video, we're gonna see cocktail sort algorithm, another sorting algorithm in Python. Now the question arises, what is cocktail sort and how does it work? So cocktail sort is nothing but just a variation of bubble sort. What in bubble sort, what we do? We swap the elements according to their order. Just like this, we do in the cocktail sort. But in this cocktail sort, we modify this bubble sort algorithm. What we do is we compare the list in two ways, first in the forward way and then in the backward way. In the forward way, we find the maximum element in the list, in the given list, and then what we put that maximum element to the rightmost part of the list. And in the reverse cycle, when we are going towards the back, what we need to do, we find the smallest of the element and we put it to the leftmost of the given list. So let's see in Python how we define our algorithm for cocktail sort. First of all, I'm going to code one file, name it as test.py. And once my file is ready, I'm going to start my program with the function itself. So my function name is cocktail sort itself. Cocktail sort. And what it will take a list as usual. Now, after taking this list, what I'm going to do, I'm going to run the loop on all over the list. So for I in range, and range would vary from length of L minus 1. We are going from the backwards, length of L minus 1 to 0, and the indexing is minus 1. Okay. And in this, what I'm going to do, I'm going to declare one variable, Boolean variable, swap, and initially it is false. So once we swap the element, it will become true. So for j in range, we are going to run the forward loop. So while in the forward loop, what we need to do, we need to check for the largest element and we put that largest element to the rightmost part of the list. So what are we going to do? We're going to the forward path, and we are going for the backward part because we are going from I to 0, that is minus 1. In the backward part, what we do, we find the smallest element and we need to put that element in the leftmost part of the list. So if L of j is less than L of j of minus 1, since we are going to the backward side, so we are comparing that with L of j minus 1, we need to swap them, L of j minus 1. We need to swap with them with L of j minus 1 and L of j. Okay. And after that, we are going to make this swap variable as true. Okay. Similarly, for the forward path, for j in range 0 to I. So we don't need to write I 0. For j in the range I, if L of j is greater than L of j plus 1. What we need to do in this case, again, we need to swap them, L of j and L of j plus 1. We need to swap them, L of j plus 1 and L of j. Okay. And once again, we need to make this swap variable as true. Okay. Once we swap the list, the swap variable becomes false once again because it will jump to the I loop and it would become false once again. So my exit condition for this loop is if my swap variable is false. So if not swapped, if it is false, then I'm going to return this list, L list, and that would be our sorted list. Now we are done with the function itself. Now I'm going to define my list. My list is fixed as I'm going to implement that one. My list is n9, 7, 2, 5, 4, 1, 12, and 3. This is my list. I'm going to call this cocktail sort function, pass this list, and whatever it returns, I need to save that in rest variable. So I'm going to store that in rest variable. And after that, I'm going to print this rest variable. So print rest. Once I hit save, I go to the terminal, run my command. And you could see we got the sorted list, perfectly sorted list. Now let's jump to the implementation of this list, how we implemented that. Implementation of cocktail sort. So this was our list initially. We go for the forward process. We find the maximum element is 12. Now, if we find the maximum element, we try to put that in the rightmost part of the list. So in the next step, what we did, we swap 3 and 12. Okay. Now we are going for the backward process, but 12 is excluded because if the largest element is already present at the rightmost part of the list, then it is at the sorted position. Now my list is 9 to 3. I found the backward part, the minimum element is 1. So I need to swap 1 with 9, leftmost part of the list. So in the next step, I swap 1 and 9. Now, once again, forward part, but my list is 7 to 3. Once again, you know why. I found maximum element to be 9. I swapped 9 and 3. So my list becomes like this. Now, my list is 3 to 7. So in this, I found minimum element to be 2. So once again, I swap 2 and 7. Okay. Now my remaining list is 7, 5, 4, 3. I found maximum element has to be 7. I swap 3 and 7. Now my list is 3, 4, 5. I found minimum element to be 3, but it is already present at the sorted position. So what I did, now I'm going to run forward loop once again. 5 and 4. I found 5 to be largest. I swap them. This is my sorted list. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 9, 12. Now there is no sublist is left to be sorted. No process is left to be went through. Neither the backward process nor the forward process. So this is my list. So we sorted the array. So that's it from this video. Hope you're having a great day ahead. Thank you. Take a body's high.